Hello student, I hope you all are fine. So in this video, I'll teach you how you can take an input and output from user keyboard. Taking an input from user and print here as an output. So how you can do that? So in this video, we'll ask a user to type his name and age. So how you can do that? Okay, this program, it will be useful those who need to learn a C program. So let's see how you can do that. Thế, hãy cái này video thì nhìn tại cái cái program và nhìn cái link và user un ai cái cái kertang chung, ya cái kertang chung u bat ya cái snap chung u. Thế cũng nó bắt pin sedang ya cái này cái program barbo. Okay, you need to declare a data type. Okay, when we need to ask a string, we use a data type in C. So there are so many data type in C, so we'll learn in next video, don't worry. So as of now, just understand this program. Okay, why we use char? Because we need to type a character. As of now, we can say it a string. So I use a name. Okay, so by default, let's do this. Okay, what happened now? So I'll declare integer. Hadin bangala de ban declare your new variable name but oh data type. Ban store your new variable name. Okay, you can store this variable name with the help of this data type. Otherwise, without data type, where you can store, right? To store any information on your mobile phone, we need an internal memory or we need an external memory. That's why you can store your music, so any information with the help of memory. So same thing here also, the example that to store an integer, we need this data type int. Okay, we use a short form. Okay, int. So age. So this is variable. So what is mean variable? Variable it mean a memory. Okay, it example the memory where you can store that name. Okay, where you can store that information. Okay, but see what type of memory you can store. So here is a character. So here is a integer. So how we can do that? Okay, now let's ask a user to type his name by using a printf. So printf. Okay, so we always do this double quote and ask a user enter your name. Okay, now after that we use a scanf to store that name. Whatever that name user enter, so we'll use a scanf with the help of percentage C or percentage A. So by default, okay, by default here I didn't declare a size of this character, so it will take zero memory or one index, a zero index. So when I print, it will print only one character. Okay, let's see what happened when, let me type this scanf. Now inside a scanf, I'll call a percentage C as of now. Okay, now I'll call this variable name. Okay, now whatever user enter here, cái ai ba user mà ba run cái này program, cái ai ba pita hàng này là store hàng này cái scanf, đặc biệt nhà presentation, but là store hàng này ha variable name, đặc biệt character năng ta for the age. Okay, so same, you can copy this same line, but you need to do some change. So how you can change here? Okay, as this correct statement, enter your age now. We'll change here the same variable. Okay, don't make mistake, whatever you declare here A only, if you declare A, so here also you need to call A, no problem that. Okay, now here I need to change percentage D. After that is need only to print, so I'll type a print F. Okay, semicolon double quote. Okay, when we need to print, okay, my name, you can write a correct statement. Okay, now call this percentage C and call this variable name. This is just a variable, we can call a variable. So next video I'll explain more what is mean this variable. Now I need to print f. Now we need to print age. Okay, my age. Okay, now so here always we call this percentage d. Okay, now don't forget to call this variable. What we need to print, you need to call that. Now let's see what happened when I, let me save first. So after I save, let me save this. Okay, simple output. Okay, simple app.c. So remember to save with the extension if you Remember last video, okay? Nè, what can my one save cùng button extension cùng tôi bằng là bắt tay hạc video của bạn là đẹp. Mình ta, okay, let me compile this program. You'll see is zero error. Now, when I run this program, okay? When I enter A, then it asks my age. Okay, now it print my name is A, my age is 12. But here, no next line because I have to declare here a slash n, okay, a backslash, don't use a front slash, a backslash n. Now when I compile, you see here when my name A and my age is 12, you see my name A, my age is 12. But here there is a problem here. If you type a correct name, okay, you see a problem here. What happened when I run this program? Let me type my correct name day and my age. See, there is a problem. Cannot store because I didn't declare a size of the my string or my character here. So let me declare here a size now. Okay, so it's better to use here percentage CS. Okay, instead of in what I mean here, instead of this C, you can change a percentage S. Now it will run successful this program. So the only change you need to put a size your this character. Okay, now you need to change instead of C to percentage S, then it will be running fine. So let me compile, okay, and run. See here, let me type here whatever I type, let me type Dengai and age. You see here my name is Dengai and my age is 12. So like this, you can take an input and print an output, okay, in simple program. So nga try come down jing e ya phi. Và phần sau đó, họ bà nghĩ đơn cam bàn tay cái cách này, nghĩ họ bàn use nè ở đây tại mà character char, so integer nghĩ use this short form int, so variable name. If you change this simple n, let's suppose and here is simple a, okay, no problem. This also will take, but you need to change your variable here wherever a or wherever is name. Like this also you can do, okay, you can put your own variable, any variable name. When you compile is no problem, okay, see it takes successful. So like this, I hope this program it make you understand well. So if you have any problem, you can comment on this video. So we'll see on next video. Thank you.